Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I am going to give you three tips on how to stop heavy bleeding. This was a question that I got when I sent out the survey in my on my email list asking you all what you wanted to see. So this question came up a lot, so I wanted to make sure I answered it. I am so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knutson. I am a certified holistic health coach and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female-related conditions using food as medicine. If this is your first time landing on my channel, welcome. If you like what you see, please consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell so you never miss an episode. So if you have issues with heavy bleeding, you may also have issues with anemia or low iron. I did a video on that topic, so I will post that link down in the description box and up in the cards for you to watch at your convenience. But let me get into the three tips as to what you can do to help stop the heavy bleeding. First off, we got to talk about the food. That's the first step. The food, the food, the food. I know y'all are sick of hearing me. I talk about it. I sound like a broken record. And I don't know how else to put it. There's no getting around it. Like, you got to get that food that causes heavy bleeding out of your diet. So that's the meat, dairy, processed foods, sugar, grains, caffeine, alcohol. If you don't have the list of foods to avoid, download it. It's a link down below and up in the cards. So I'll just keep that pretty short because you got to stop doing the thing, or at least one of the main things that's causing the problem in the first place. If you expect something to change in this area and you don't want to change your diet, or you're unwilling to make the changes in your diet, I don't know what to tell you. There's no, like, I tried everything. There's just, there, I haven't been able to find a way around it. And if you've found a way around it, let me know. There are even some people that I've heard say to me, and I'm like, I think it's laughable. They'll say, oh, well, if you just take this herb, it'll cause your bleeding to stop. No, it won't. It'll help. But if you keep on doing the thing that's causing the bleeding, it's impossible for the herb to help. I mean, it might help a little bit, but it's not going to help to heal the problem. Herbs in combination with you changing your diet, yes, I will agree with that. But just you going and taking some herb and thinking the bleeding is going to stop and the problem's going to go away, that's a pipe dream, I believe. So, because if that could have happened or if that could have worked, let me tell you, I would have made it work. Because I'm telling you, I looked for it. So, anyway, I just wanted to say that. And, of course, if you need help finding what to eat, look on my YouTube channel. There's plenty of free recipes on there for you to follow to get yourself started. And I'm adding more and more every week. Okay, so this one here, I always get people saying, why would you say that? Can I eat this or can I eat that? So this is number two, and the biggest culprit, I think, to heavy bleeding is grains. And the reason I think that they are a big culprit is because our guts are so messed up from all of the junk that we have eaten our whole life. And even the people who have had a halfway decent diet, or they consider their diet healthy, grains are still not good for those people if they have female reproductive issues. So what happens is when someone has female reproductive issues, their gut is a mess. Like, their digestive system is backed up. Sometimes they have really bad digestive issues. Like, their body is not even digesting the food that they eat. It's coming out the same way it went in. Or it's just not coming out. They're constipated. Most people struggle with constipation and don't even know it. Just because they have one poop a day, they think that they're not constipated. And the reality is, if you have eaten three meals in a day and you have only pooped once, where is that other food? And if you have done that most of your life, where is that food? even if you've had times in your life where you've gone a couple times, three times a day, sometimes four times a day, where is the other food that didn't come out when you ate it? And even when you start on this program, lots of people will tell me, oh yeah, I started pooping 3 and 4 and 5 times a day since I've been eating this food. Well, that's great. I'm glad that that is happening for you. But where is the food that you ate for 20 years that didn't come out? It's still in there. So you've got to give your body time to get it out. So what grains do when your body is full of toxic waste is cause inflammation in the body. And that inflammation shows up in painful periods or heavy menstrual cycles. So also when you eat grains, they kind of get a gluey consistency when they get into your digestive tract. And when they're gluey, what does glue do? It sticks. So it's getting stuck in your digestive tract. Your body's already having a hard enough time trying to push out all that old stuff. And when you're trying to shrink fibroids or get rid of symptoms and things of that nature, the last thing your body needs to be working on is trying to digest things that are unnecessary. It's already trying to get rid of the old stuff so that it can go after the toxic waste that's causing your problems in the first place. So even the food, even the grains that are considered gluten-free, doughs, pastas, even the things like spelt and wild rice, I would just say no to. Just give your body a break from them until your body actually, you gain some healing. If you don't have any heavy periods or symptoms for, 6 months at all, then I might test it and try it if you just are desperate to have it. But do it until your body is completely healed. If I were in your shoes, that's what I would do my best to do. I'm not talking about perfection, but just do your best. I just know that from working with hundreds of women that when they get rid of the grains, their symptoms start to go away, including myself. That's what happened to me. And last but not least, we really have to get control of our emotions. Emotions really play a factor in whether or not you have things going on in your body in general. And usually the emotions that are associated with female reproductive issues is anger, bitterness, and resentment. Those three are a triple threat, and a lot of women don't even know they're walking around with those three emotions. Oh, the other one too that goes along with that is fear. And so when you walk around with those negative emotions, or you're walking around with unforgiveness that's associated with those issues, then your body responds to it. So if you've got negative emotions going on, your body doesn't know the difference between what's real and imagined. So even if the situations that you are bitter or angry about or resentful about are real situations, or if they're even made up situations in your head for whatever reason, your body thinks that they're real, and your body will get sick or hold on to sickness while you are experiencing those negative emotions. So you've got to do whatever you've got to do to get rid of them. I work with women all the time on how to alleviate these emotions. I do talk about it and work with the women in my 90-day Walk to Freedom from Fibroids group coaching program. I do give them techniques and tips and all that stuff. But the reality is, working in a group setting is difficult to get to the nitty-gritty of somebody's personal reasons as to why they are having those negative emotions and pulling out the root and working with them specifically when there's a group setting. But we do talk about it in the 90-day program, and I do give you tips on how to do that. But whenever I work with women and they really want to get control of their emotions, that's when I do a lot of work one-on-one. So if you are struggling with negative emotions and you need some help, you may want to consider signing up for one of my 10-minute sessions so that we can talk briefly about it and then figure out if working together would be an option for you if you are struggling with these negative emotions. But they will keep you bound up, bleeding heavy. The fibroids won't necessarily go away. Like, you might feel some relief, but like, I think that they absolutely have something to do with the root of why you are in the situation with the female health issue in the first place. I'm finding out that it's almost always something associated with those. Fear, bitterness, anger, resentment, those types of things. So let me give you this other piece of it. If there's something that you go to sleep with every night, it's the thing that's on your mind. It's also the thing on your mind when you go to bed at night. I mean, when you wake up in the morning. It's also the thing that you're thinking about when you see a particular person, or if you think of a person, you got all these negative emotions going on inside of you. You're ruminating over it. Like, the thoughts about that person or the situation is just going over and over and over and over again on in your mind. You need to work on it if that's the case. And I know how it is because I've been there. But you got to do a mind shift, and it takes some work. But you're worth it. You're worth it. The reason you're worth it is because you weren't meant to live a life walking around with negative emotions all the time. That's not how God created you to live. Not that bad things wouldn't happen, but that you would not be controlled by negative emotions. You should not walk around fearful and bitter and angry. That is not how we were meant to be. So now you know 3 of my tips on how to stop heavy bleeding. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. But until next time, y'all, take care.